Poster presentation number 60, improving participation of clinicians in hospitals in the malaria awareness programs conducted during the prevention of reintroduction phase in malaria in Sri Lanka by Jayasena, AKSS, Ranaweera, KDNP, Muzrif, Karunaratna S, Ratnayake, KASD. Paper presented by Jayasena, AKSS.
Very good morning to all of you, chairpersons, ladies and gentlemen. I am Dr. Sarangi Jayasena from Anti-Malaria Campaign, graduate from Wuhan University, and I did my master's in community medicine. This is the presentation I'm going to do in Anti-Malaria Campaign. We conduct clinician training programs. These data. Improving participation of clinicians in hospitals in the malaria awareness programs conducted during the prevention of reintroduction phase of malaria in Sri Lanka. And there are like 356 imported malaria cases reported since the elimination in 2012, and 53 imported malaria cases in 2019, last year. The diagnosis was made after the day 5 of admission in 25% of patients, and due to not considering of taking travel history or possibility of malaria. The clinician training program must be continued for clinicians of hospitals to maintain zero mortality due to malaria, zero mortality due to malaria. That's one of the objectives in anti-malaria campaign. The method I used, considering the highest number of cases reported previous years and vulnerability of the hospitals, secondary and tertiary level hospitals, conducted the clinician training programs. We selected 6 hospitals from Western Province and 4 hospitals from other provinces. From Western Province, selected hospitals are National Hospital Sri Lanka, Colombo South Teaching Hospital, Colombo North Teaching Hospital, Sri Jayawardenepura Hospital, and Kaluthara and Nigambo General Hospital, and also Base Hospital, Homagama. In other provinces, Teaching Hospital Kandy and Teaching Hospital Peradeniya, then also General Hospital Mathura and Base Hospital, Karvanala. The participants' attendance were marked during the entrance, and they were requested to wait until the program was over. The results, the data was analyzed of all these 10 hospital attendants. The total number of participants was 572 in all 10 hospitals. The consultants and senior registrars participants was 8.39%, in number 48. Medical officers, registrars, house officers, and medical students participants was 61% majority. They were from number 349. Nursing officers' participation also was good, 16.28, 93%. And other medical laboratory technicians, public health laboratory technicians, participation was 9.61. The number was 55. The participants, there were like 27 who did not mention their category. In conclusion, it is recommended to participate of clinician training programs by the consultants, and because they are the and also OPD staff, because they are the first contact medical officers who will take the travel history from the patients. So malaria should be included in the differential diagnosis to reduce the complications of late stage. Thank you very much. Any
Thank
questions?
Thank you. The paper is now open for discussion.
So other than the attendance data, did you look at, say, for example, the proportion of participants from each hospital in the different categories, or the reasons for participation and non-participation?
Actually, these clinician training programs were conducted, which was funded by WHO. So our participants was like only planned to participation of 30 from one hospital. Mm-hmm. So altogether, like from 10 hospitals, it is recommended like 300. But it's participation was remarkably high, 572. In NHSL, when there's majority of patients, postgraduate students, they were really interested, and they were like 150. So we have to arrange more to accommodate a lot of participation. base hospitals. Also, they were really enthusiastic because we got malaria patients from those hospitals. In different hospitals also, we have data, but I have not analyzed the data here.
Did you maintain a list of the number of invitees?
Yes, I do have. Invitees, because I have requested for the consultants and OPD MOs, so we have requested at least OPD MOs and ETU, ICU MOs, they are the places that you will get unconscious patients.
So was it more sensible to make the decision based on the number of invitees as participation as a percentage?
No, we didn't make a specific list of invitees. It's an open invitation to the hospital.
Right.
So we want mainly OPD doctors and ICU and PCU doctors to attend and consultant as well. And we would like to continue the same clinician training programs in the future.
Thank you for the presentation. Let's thank the presenter in the traditional manner.